It's news time. Information is power. Be current. The news headline. IPOB members in Cyprus swear oath of allegiance call for Inadekanu's release. The members of the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, in Cyprus have called for the immediate release of their leader, Mazen Adekanu, who is currently in the detention of the Department of State Services, DSS. Also, some young persons were inducted into the group after they took an oath of allegiance at a local venue in Limassol, a city in the southern coast of Cyprus. Nigeria Broad reports. IPOB has, however, denied reports describing its activities as that of a terrorist organization, saying it is fighting for the freedom of Southeasterners amid worsening insecurity in the region. A now deleted tweet stated yesterday, 12 December 2021, IPOB in Limassol, Cyprus, led by our great leader, Mazen Adekanu, administered oaths of allegiance to our new members, adding that the group remained resolute in its campaign to restore sovereignty for Biafra. The IPOB leader, IPOB followers have been active in Cyprus through social media posts and public demonstrations where young men and women often display flags, chant freedom slogans, and sing peace songs. In May 2020, Greek Cyprus immigration officers rounded up asylum seekers from their places of residence on the island, that is Biafra agitators, with some complaining that they were being moved to a migrant camp under threat of deportation. Kanu is currently detained in the facility of the DSS on the order of Justice Binta Nyakole Federal High Court, Abuja, on treasonable felony charges preferred against him by the Nigerian government. Kanu was illegally arrested in Kenya and renditioned to Nigeria in June. The separatist leader recently accused the Nigerian government of violating his human rights, alleging that the doctor had been instructed by security agents to take his blood sample 21 times. Additional complaints from the activists prompted a federal court earlier this month to demand that the IPOB leader should be allowed to have maximum comfort while in detention, meaning he would have a change of clothes, better food, accept visits, and practice his faith freely. And this was the news from Cyprus. IPOB saying that they have actually hijacked up and also to ensure that the new persons that they were just inducted into the indigenous people of Biafra group, after taking the oath of allegiance, that they would ensure that they participate fully in the activities of the IPOB without involving in anything terrorism, to ensure that the Southeasterners are free from the bondage of being associated with Nigeria, since all they are doing is clamoring for a breakup from the body of Nigeria. And said he had also been a victim of the bandits on several occasions. Also, in our mosque, we have paid ransom. Even now, somebody is asking me to assist him to pay ransom. Our family driver, who happens to be our relative, his son, a private soldier, was killed by bandits. So how can I support such people? Gumi told Premium Times. The Islamic cleric, who said his efforts with bandits had been sabotaged recently, said he has quit meeting with bandits because it would be dangerous for him to continue to engage with them, especially while they had been tagged as terrorists. Gumi described those calling for his arrest as not different from bandits, stressing that it is a constitutional right for someone to express his views. The cleric said his efforts is to prevent banditry in his own way, stating that he has also been a victim of banditry. They are clowns. They don't know anything about the Nigerian society. They do not know about the Nigerian constitution and liberty. It is a constitutional right for someone to express his view, so long you are not calling for violence or harm anybody. These people calling for my arrest, I do not see anything different from bandits, and to say that I am supporting or sponsoring bandits is malicious. I am trying to cure them in my own way. I am trying to prevent it in my own way, and I have seen my little efforts have helped. I just have different perspective in addressing the issue, but to encourage them, no. To help them, no. It is impossible, for I am also a victim of banditry and would never support them. And that is why I have even quit meeting with any of these bandits.
The president lacks the power to get Inamdekanu released without completing the trial. Festus Kenyamo repeated the pretentious position that the president lacks the power to end the trial. And today, Malami, the attorney general, repeated the same position by suggesting that discussions of release of Nnamdi Kanu are premature because Nnamdi Kanu is still standing trial. In other words, Malami wants the trial to be completed before pardon could be discussed. He wants Nnamdi Kanu to be convicted and sentenced to death or life before he could be granted pardon and then released. Ironically, Malami can end trial with only two paragraphs of written statements entering nulli prosequi in the case. The funny thing is that my Uwanize brothers may think that they are smart and that they are, you know, and that they are making progress over Nnamdi Kanu's case when in fact they are complicating matters. Uwanize moves may actually turn out against Nnamdi Kanu. They are pleading for forgiveness, which is an admission that Nnamdi Kanu committed the offences. The leader of the Uwanize delegation was quoted to be assuring Buhari that, "I know how to control him. If you release him to me, I will get him to stop saying those things he was saying." In other words, he admitted that Nnamdi Kanu was inciting violence and preaching ethnic hatred, but that he could stop him from continuing to commit those offences. The Nigerian government is yet to prove in court that it was indeed Nnamdi Kanu that was making those broadcasts, but our Uwanize elders already admitted that fact, thus providing for the state the evidence they may actually not have at trial. If Nnamdi Kanu had a good lawyer, he would have made some critical advances in the case and would have advised Uwanize to sit back and watch for the time being. Instead, because there is no good lawyer for Nnamdi Kanu, Uwanize is so confused. The Uwanize members don't know how to approach this case. They come in as observers of the trial and get denied entry into the courtroom. They monitor the trial from the corridors and parking the lot, and came as delegates to the president to ask for amnesty, but end up admitting to the offences charged. It is clear that Uwanize is at loss, and the president is far more calculated and is ahead of them in strategy and thinking. President will listen to the advice of his attorney general before deciding how to respond to the Uwanize people, and the attorney general will tell the president that the discussions with Uwanize is premature, that he should wait until Kanu is convicted. At the present pace of progress in the trial will not be completed in the next 3 years. But also, the trial can be sped up if Nnamdi Kanu pleads guilty to some of the charges by the way of plea bargain. In other words, the government will ask Nnamdi Kanu to plead guilty to some of the charges in order for the government to drop the other charges and be sentenced to time already served in detention.